In this video, I'm going to show you how to use and what's the difference between tags and segments in ConvertKit, which is the absolute best email marketing tool. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Welcome to Yes to Tech, where we empower non-techie online entrepreneurs like you to maximize your online presence. First of all, if you don't have a ConvertKit account already, click on the link in the description box below to create your account right away. ConvertKit's tags and segments are great since they allow you to add or exclude specific groups of subscribers from the email broadcasts you create. The essential difference between tags and segments is that segments are composed of a number of tags, meaning that they group a greater number of subscribers together, and tags are more specific. For example, I created a segment with all of my subscribers who are currently enrolled in my welcome sequence or in my free email course. And as you can see, this segment over here is composed of a number of tags. To create a new tag, go to the Subscribers tab in ConvertKit, locate where it says Tags on the right-hand side, and at the bottom of that section, click on plus create a tag. Then just name the tag whatever you'd like and press save. Let's just create another tag again. So let's scroll all the way down the tag section, click on plus create a tag, name that tag and press save. Now the steps to create a segment are pretty much the same. Go to the Subscribers tab in ConvertKit, locate where it says Segments, and at the bottom of that section, click on plus create a segment. Name that segment whatever you'd like. And from here, we can select the subscribers who'll be a part of that segment, so this segment over here, based on a number of filters. From this first drop-down menu, you can select whether the filter should match any, all, or none of the parameters you select. Then click on plus add filter, and from the options available, select your first parameter. So it can match the following parameters: all subscribers, subscribed to, within segment, cold subscribers, within a country or region, distance from a city, subscription date, first name, email address, and custom field. So I'm going to select subscribers that are subscribed to the tag that we just created. Just test tag one, and then I'll go ahead and click on add filter. Now from there, you can either add another filter by clicking on plus add filter that matches this parameter over here that you had previously set, or click on plus add filter group to add a filter that matches another parameter. So let's match one that matches none of the following. Click on plus add filter and subscribe to the tag of test tag two that we created, and then click on add filter. So this test segment over here will be any of the subscribers that match test tag one and include none of the subscribers that match test tag two. Then click on save once you are done. And that's it. Now you know how to use and how to create both tags and segments in ConvertKit to easily segment your email subscribers. To take things to the next level, make sure to watch my video on how to schedule and send emails in ConvertKit. Again, if you don't have a ConvertKit account yet, just click the link in the description box below to create your account right away. I now want to hear from you. Let me know in the comments below one of the segments you've created for your email list and what tags you've added to it. If you're interested in learning about even more brilliant tools you can use to run your online business, make sure to download the free cheat sheet with the 9 absolute best tools to run your online business by clicking on the link in the description box below. If you liked this video, give me a like below, share it with your friends, and make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.